What up, guys? I am Grumbles. I am back again. I just made a video, and you should go check that out for a common law defense for Culture Lane and for people who are getting vaccination orders. Okay, like, no. Okay, easy defense for that. You can go check that video out. This is going to be a video maybe disturbing for some people. It's a little bit disturbing for me as well, having to be and living in this time and really trying to understand how we got here and what are we supposed to do to get out of the hole that we're in, okay? As far as people being completely debt slaves, okay? It's not funny, okay? It might be, it's never talked about. It's just like, oh, these people have jobs, and it's like, okay, yeah, now they got jobs. They're going to be broke in less than a year. They're all paying rent. They don't own nothing, okay? They got people out there advocating to take away our rights, okay? We got really serious problems going on here. And my solutions may not be the best solutions, okay? But I'm going to go with the law and what's already written down to stop what's going on, because we already had these problems in the past. We just didn't have this kind of technology to really brainwash this many people out there. And this is my opinion, okay? Now, as far as like what to do, I mean, there's not really much like action. I mean, it's really more about knowledge, and especially like what I said, pushing, making sure people understand the difference between code of law and constitutional law, because a lot of times they get wrapped up, especially when they go to the DMV, and they just think that the government can do whatever they want when they're getting away with paying, having to pay these tickets and having to forfeit property, you know, and it's like, well, you ain't free, but you ain't free, you know, maybe you told you were free, but if you don't understand basic common law, okay, and private property, you're not free, okay? And my channel has been mainly about getting the knowledge out there to pretty much be in a position where I'm at now. I can sit here and make fucking videos, which I don't even do, you know. I play video games. I have fun, you know. I'm building a property on my house right now. Property on my house. Building a house on my property. Okay, I'm building a Connex house. So I got three storage containers. They're totally insulated already. I got the foundation. I'm just trying to get them on there right now, and then I'm gonna start building it. Okay, hopefully I'll be able to do it. I got hurt recently digging. Go figure that, right? My worst enemy is digging. I'm being serious. I hate digging. And then finally, this, like, you get property just like you get forced to dig. It's like you got nothing else to do. It's like, well, you got to get these trenches built. You got to get the power lines in. You got to get the water lines in. You got so much stuff to do. You want to do it. And I'm a hands-on dude. I mean, I was out there 24/7. I just pulled my back out and did too much of it. But you know, I'm going off on a tangent about something else now. Anyways, so back to like future plans. So this will be mostly really extreme here. But honestly, I think if stuff starts getting out of hand, like they're already, like the government really tries confiscating guns and they're killing babies after they're born. Like stuff starts really getting out of hand. Like we're close to it. I really think that now is the time that we should start forming militias, armed militias, and start heading over to police departments and FBI headquarters. And whether we should like all write them letters or even show up there all at once, we don't have to be necessarily armed. I'm just saying, like, we need to tell them in a way that, hey, can you guys do your fucking jobs? And what I mean by that is the law is pretty clear that when you have treasonous people in your government, they're supposed to be fucking removed. And the problem is today we have the internet. I mean, that's not the problem. That's a great thing. We have the internet. The problem is that these people are using this to push all their anti-American, anti-constitution invasion on, especially with the real invasion going on. If you don't know what I'm talking about, I don't know, you've been living under a rock and there's no hope for you. Okay, so the law is already there for them to go and physically remove them. And basically I'd be petitioning them to say, hey, like, they're calling our fucking bluff right now, 2019, as it stands. The law says we have to go physically remove them and kill them if necessary, if they don't go peacefully. So we'll be like, yo, can you guys go do that so we don't have to go do that? So you guys are going to try shooting, killing us, trying to do that? Like, it's not going to go well. Okay, so it's like, Can you guys go like our specific examples where it's like known and admitted, where the military tribunals will take less than a day? Again, they get military tribunals. They pretend on TV it's the opposite when it's really, it's like a warped fucking reality we're living in. They force this code of law onto the American public, okay? When they're the only ones held to the code of law. And then when they get in trouble, like Hillary Clinton, they pretend as if they're not corporations now, or they're not public officials. Nothing private about them. They can't go into court like we just talked in my last video and do what they do. They can't do that. They got military tribunals. Their case is done. What I'm saying is, if they're not going peacefully, okay, they ignore the courts. They're just doing whatever they want, okay? Can the cops and law enforcement go arrest them and have military tribunals? Because we are going, they're calling our bluff, okay, basically. And it's like, well, if you don't do something soon by so-and-so date or whatever, okay, that we will. And we're asking you to stand down. We're asking you not to shoot at us. And we're going to sign up a paper here, maybe sign a form, go through and say, hey, we swear to pledge not to shoot at police officers, not to shoot at Secret Service agents, not to shoot at anybody shooting at us if we literally go in there to remove Nancy Pelosi, Chuck Schumer, those two specifically, because they are on record admitted treason on record. And at the very least, if you don't want to believe that, it's a violation of oath of office and they have to be removed. Violation of oath of office, they need to be fucking removed by their own admission. So now, that is a more extreme measure, but I think it's the most peaceful too, because what else are we supposed to do? Just sporadically show up one day with guns and say, get the fuck out of here? It's like, no. They're playing a fucked up game of calling our bluff, and we gotta like politely inform the enforcement of the police officers that we have the right to remove them, and we're gonna fucking do it, and you're gonna be make a decision. Do you want to shoot on us? You're gonna take the risk that we're not gonna shoot back? Why would you want to allow this to happen on your country? Why don't you just do the right thing and follow the law? Okay? We ain't going to have no problems here. These people want to continue to go on TV and advocate for the hatred of Americans and the downfall of our Constitution and blame gun owners for a kid's death when they're the ones that should be blaming themselves for disarming people in the first place. I mean, it's common sense. It's common fucking sense. I don't know what else to say about that, but that's pretty much like, and I was watching a video on Zoom Truth, and he was like, what do we do? And I'm like, I have ideas about what to do, and I've been implementing this, especially for personal, not just what I've said now, but I mean like for personal things, like I said, buying property, you know, not paying rent, okay? I'd rather live 5 years on the street in a tent than 20 years comfortable and then on the street for the rest of my life. I don't know, I guess I'm stupid in that way. But when you see these people and, oh, I got a good job. Okay, I mean, you sure that job is going to last you for 20 years? Because you're spending 90% of it on throwing it away every month. You're not saving it so you can acquire yourself some land, some private property, a vehicle that's owned, like me, what I've done. Like when I started making these videos, not really even talking, when I just started posting and you could look back, I was in debt and broke. That's right. I was debt $3,000 and broke. And now let me tell you something. You could say I'm almost rich now, but I mean, I'm not rich by any means. But from where I am now, I worked hardly as much. Just with the knowledge of what I was doing and allocating my resources and getting the market, getting things. Like when the housing market crashed, I took advantage of that. I mean, I couldn't take advantage of it right away. I was broke with nothing. I was lucky and fortunate enough that it stayed that way. You know, I basically made it to the last year, and like the year after, everything started going up again little by little. And I made my money that way. But you could still try to find a fixer-upper somewhere, and you don't have to live in a tent. Save some money, get a fixer-upper, and live in that piece of shit for a few years before it takes you time to fix it up properly. And I guarantee you'll be much better off afterwards. As far as the code of law goes, learn code of law, learn what they've been doing, okay? Not follow through it as much as you can. If you go to court and you comply, don't look at it as a fucking loss. It's a learning experience. These people have been doing this for a long time. They got really good at it, okay? Just because they can convince 90% of us or 99% of us to do something doesn't mean they can convince me. We still have the law on our side. Whether you guys want to give up or see, it's not worth it anymore. Oh, what could we do? You know, everybody just goes along with it. This is what we can do. Starting by getting the knowledge out, so when people start going to court, not for non-traffic issues, I'm not talking about traffic, okay? I'm talking about, like, the situation I got before, like, okay, like, with these people accuse you of stuff, and the government wants to get involved and try putting all their bullshit on top of you, you know, just because you admit stuff, now they got to do, you know, community service or pay fines or go on probation. You wouldn't believe what they threatened me with my son if I didn't go along with their BS. So, yo, you just got to plead that you were guilty and do it to this. And if you, sorry, excuse me. If you watch my video where I go into that, I forgot exactly what, probably just court one of those around there, but if you watch them, I go into exactly what happened, you know, and how I got wrapped up in it, because once I lured up, like, I got my family, this lady's coming after my baby, you know what I'm saying? I still wasn't 100% what I am now. I'm still learning, okay? So I was really, like, I was worried, okay? Like I, you know, so I had to do what I had to do. But basically, even in the middle of it, I was like, no, fuck that. I'm like, no. I'm not going in there saying I'm guilty. It's not happening. I wasn't guilty, you know? And I was just so mad, you know? And they knew they were guilty. The other side knew they were wrong. They were lying motherfuckers, okay? And I'm just like, I had it. I'm like, forget it. You know, I'm going to go to the end. I was like, yo, let this motherfucker do that. Let me lose and do that, because I was going to rip his fucking head off. All right. Not literally, but I mean, I would have beat his ass. Let's just put it that way. Maybe not even just once, you know, it's something like he would have lied that much and I would actually lost in court, but they came back and was like, no, that's all right. You just have to say no contest and you're good. Pay this small fine and you're good. That's easy for me. That's fine with me. It's fine with me. Okay. But if I knew a lot of knowledge that I know now, and I knew a lot then, I did know a lot more. I mean, I was really this close. I was this close because technically I didn't get a lawyer yet. I mean, I had a lawyer, but my first court appearance, like I said, I appeared as myself. The case was ultimately dismissed. This guy lied against it. I violated the probation. Then we had to go to court again. This guy, he's the same guy coming after my son because my baby mama's dead. So I had some problems, okay? So I lawyered up. Okay, my family's gonna tell me, give me some money. They helped me out with some money. It cost like $5,000 overall. Okay, but I mean, I'm gonna say long story short because I go into a little bit now. But I was saying I was this close to just because I knew a lot and I knew what to do to get out of it because I was like, now I'm screwed because I got a lawyer now. I'm going through it all in my head now because they're like, you got to do that. I can't believe I'm just beside myself because I know I'm mad. I didn't do anything wrong. I just can't believe that they're believing this guy. Like, there's no evidence. There's no witnesses. In fact, I had witnesses, but he was like hiding her or something like that. I couldn't find. He took away her phone. There's a lot going on that I'm just not going into. Like, so, like, I didn't even have my witness with me. So, but I was this close to going in there and be like, I fired my lawyer. You know, I am not corporation, you know, going right back in. I was this close to just trying to, and I would have, and I'm pretty sure I would have gotten it. I'm pretty sure I knew enough to where it still would have been my word against his, and the case would have been dismissed. Okay, I wouldn't have had to pay no fine. I wouldn't have had to do no community service. However, if I did lose, you know, I would have mandatory visits with my son. It was like ridiculous kind of stuff they were threatening me with. So to pay a small fine, not admit that I'm guilty, okay, that was very important for me, just for myself. Have it on record that I'm admitting to causing harm to somebody. That's not who I am. That goes against every principle of libertarianism. And I was just so irate in my head. I was just so irate. But I'm glad it's over with now. I'm glad it went the way it did. I got to learn a lot, which is very important. And I get to share my experience with you guys. And hopefully there's at least, I know my, I'm like 70 people in my last videos is terrible. And my subscriber count is awful, okay? As soon as they demonetize me, no one sees my videos anymore. That's why I've been kind of depressed too lately, this last month, 2 months. It's like, I don't even see the point in making new videos if nobody's going to see them. Not like I got paid. It's not about that. It was about because they get shoved that people can see them. Now they're like shadow banning. They're nobody seeing them. You know, like, except the people that are already in the club. There's not really anybody new, you know, unless you're like specifically looking up and you scroll down a bunch, maybe. I mean, anyways, I mean, yeah, so the plans, I mean, that's my plans. That's what I say what the plans should be. I don't really know what to say. I mean, some people want to start talking about how to get out of the driver's license thing, and I've been thinking more and more about that recently because I did go back. I flip on this all the time. I go back and forth on getting the driver's license, not getting the driver's. Again, I'm going to say, like, if you never got the driver's license, you should not get it. You should. It's a good thing. It's really good. Okay, but if you do have it, it's kind of hard to get out of it. I'm thinking about it. I'm thinking about trying to do that because I want to go to the DMV and say I want this canceled out because I'm afraid of driving and I don't want to drive no more. And I can't. I don't want it expired. I don't want it suspended. I want the contract canceled out completely. And I'm honestly really, really thinking about doing this because I know I said that in the short term, it's probably because you won't get arrested. But honestly, you might not get arrested anyways, depending on the cop. And we do have the law on our side. The law is there. If you can politely, especially if you live in a small town, again, variables dependent on everything that I'm talking about here. Every situations are critical, okay? Especially if you're in a big city, I will never recommend that. You will never get. I just won't recommend it, okay? It's just not going to happen. It would take years to for them to know who you are to stop messing with you, and you would be in court all the time. I just, like I said, if you're in a small town, I'm literally considering it because, again, we have the right to travel. And now, on top of that, if your vehicle is private property, if you don't know what I'm talking about, again, your vehicle is not private property. When you go to the DMV and you hand them over the MSO, the Manifesto Certificate of Origin, they hand you back a title with your name on it. That's handing over your private property rights. So now they can do what they want. So again, if I get that done, because I'm going to buy a new car soon, okay? If I get it, and it has to be a brand new car. It has to be the first owner. You can't just be buying it for somebody seeing you. That's not how it works, okay? You got to get the car from the dealership. You got to get that original MSO. Go to an insurance company and get a plate with them, okay? You can pay your insurance if you want, but still do not get your car registered. That's the worst thing you can do. So what I recommend is get your moped registered or some kind of other kind of vehicle registered that would be cheap so you can get your sticker or whatever the hell they do in your state just so you don't get harassed by the police. And basically that's my plan for that. Get to the DMV and let people know you don't need another permission. You already have permission. We're free. That's why we live in a free country. The corporations have to go there. Okay, the police officers have to get plates on their car. Do you have the corporations that have like delivering paint? They have to get plates on their car. Okay, felons, I would believe, have to get plates on their car. Okay, same things. I mean, it doesn't go into that specifically, but that's basically this. You can easily apply that to felons. Okay, if you're a felon, you got to get your shit registered. You got to have your shit. You just got to get your shit together. You know what I'm saying? So basically, that's my view on plans on what should we be doing. Okay, you want to talk about like flat Earth activism? Okay, I'm with that. I'm down with that. Especially if people know what they're talking about. I can't stand when I watch a video and these people ask questions about it, and they just don't have the right answer. Like, they just don't give them... Well, in my opinion, they don't give them the right answer. They're just like... Or they ignore easy questions. You know, and I get that, because a lot of times I get the same question all the time, and it's like, oh, you fucking noob. Like, how many times can you answer the same goddamn question? And for those of you who don't know what I'm talking about, welcome to the party. 8 inches per mile squared has been blasted and fraud. It's not accurate. It's not true. It's bullshit. Okay? And then as far as like space, you know, that too is up in the air. You know, whether they're faking it sometimes to save money, I have no idea. The fact is they faking it. Whether they faking it all the time, that's up for debate. The fact is they faking it. And if they ain't faking it, okay, if the Earth is a spinning ball with the size and mass that they give, because that's important. It's always just with the size and mass that they give, because I don't want to be labeled a flat earther. I am labeled a flat earther. And sometimes I can play devil's advocate and pretend to be a flat earther. Ultimately, I don't really believe that. Ultimately, I believe we live in a realm at this point in my life. Because Before, I would think you cannot possibly imagine people living in a flat earth believing that. And once I found out that to be true, and I found out and I saw the proofs in the and it took me a little while. I'm not gonna admit, I'm not the perfect person, but I had a lot of cognitive dissonance. All right, it took me a little while to really grasp. I had a lot of questions. Basically, once almost all my questions got answered, I really reassessed everything and was like, wow, we've been totally been lied to. And like I said, whether the earth's are flat is really irrelevant. Fact is, we've been lied to. That if you can't understand perspective and 8 inches per mile squared is just perspective, like telephone poles, when you see the curve of the earth. And when you now that I understand that there's people who've seen this evidence and still don't can't comprehend it, they still think they live on a spinning ball. If that's true, if that's reality, my reality is not true. But wait, I know my reality is true, just like that person knows his reality is true as well, right? He knows it is mobile. I know that that's not true. Okay, it could be much bigger. It could be moving much slower. I don't know that. That's a belief. I don't think that's true either because the evidence doesn't point that way. You have a lot of fake bullshit pointing that way. Fantasy, actually, every single proof of the globe is deception and proves a flat earth. If you actually look into it, it proves that this flat is no curve. That's what I mean by flat earth. There's no curve. Okay? No curve on the X and Y axis. The horizon is just, that's the vanishing point. This is too far away to see where the sky meets the floor. Okay? It's this basic common fucking knowledge. It's common sense. It's like saying Billy Mitchell. It's like saying Billy Mitchell is still champion of Kong. Why? He's been proven not to be champion of Kong. How? Look into it. Okay? So then you still have people coming out saying, no, he is. He got the score. Here it is. Here's the video. To point out to the end of the day that's emulators and how we know it's proof. These people are just so fucking stupid. But if you want to go the other way, where they literally are seeing something else than what we're seeing, okay? This is we're not comprehending each other, understanding each other properly. Two truths cannot be they cannot be two in our reality, unless we live in some kind of realm or a simulation, which is like I said, now I understand that there are crazy people out there who for some reason can't understand perspective in this day and age once they're shown the proof and how fisheye lenses work and that there's no curve of 50 miles up. The space station, whether it exists or not, I think it's just a drone flying around. Okay, now, not that fast, by the way. It's not fast if you could the size of the Earth that they give. That's the exact size it would have to go to circumnavigate it. That's why they can't change the freaking mass or whatever, in my opinion. But there's no curve up there. Okay, so whatever you think, you saw pictures. You know why those pictures are not real? They admit that their images are ribbons from satellites or what I like to call drones. From drones getting ribbons and they put the ribbons together and they throw it on the ball. The hell are you talking about? I know. They admit this. They go, oh, well, so what? Oh, so what? Why don't they go take a freaking one picture? It's so simple and so what? What are they doing all this crap for? Huh? Oh. Oh, I'm sorry. You can't get past the plasma radiation that's up there. My bad. I didn't realize that. That's why you gotta take ribbons and fool people like that. Wait. What about the shit on Mars? And or and things on Pluto. Now you see what the he said, wait a minute. Yeah, everything they show you was complete bullshit. But anyways, this video is getting way too long. I'm not sure when I'm gonna make another video because like I said, man, I said everything on here. I already got my plans. I mean, when you see people's videos, they're trying to make money or they just talking about the news every day. I'm talking about shit that's gonna help you out. My channel promotes shit that actually could be fucking taken. My channel promotes laws that are already on the fucking books. We don't need to be changing no immigration law. You want to change immigration laws on asylums? Fine. We got perfect immigration law. That's why it's called common law. That's why we need a wall. Because once they come over here, they're human beings. You cannot touch another human being unless there's a victim or a reason to do so. You can't just, oh, you don't belong here. Says who? I don't fucking belong here. And no, I ain't no advocating for no illegal immigration. Hell no. But if you're illegally here and you ain't hurting nobody, you're fine. You're protected under the fucking law. You go out and protest and raise that flag, I hope you get fucking killed. Okay? I hope that's my fucking stance, that people understand what the hell I'm talking about. Anyway, so again, I don't know when I'm going to make a video again. I comment all the time. I'm always on YouTube commenting all the time, okay? Zoom Truth invited me on his channel again. I don't know when he's gonna send me an invite or whatever, send me a comments or whatever. And you know, I'm pretty much available almost all the time, pretty much. I mean, like I said, I'm waiting on build this house. I got to put on the foundation. I got a lot of stuff gonna be going on, but up until then, I just be killing weeds. There ain't nothing really else going on. But let me get up to that real quick. I got so many weeds grow out here. It's not even funny. There was a desert for years. That's why I moved to a desert, to get away from green grass growing and bugs and shit. All of a sudden now. You want to stop global warming? Maybe stop the planes from blocking the sun and throwing aluminum all over the fucking place. And maybe you can stop your BS. All right? That's a good one. Other than that, Grumble's out. Hope you enjoyed the video. Like, subscribe. Peace out till next time.